Stay in the moment. Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. These self-doubts that you have in your mind right now, these thoughts racing back and forth in your mind, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. You're in the moment. Here. You and I. What do those problems matter? What could those problems in your mind racing back and forth, what could they have to do with right now? That's what you need to hear. You need to hear. Stop it. Stop that. Quit thinking those things. Release yourself from your burdens. Release yourself from your mistakes of the day. You can't do it. You know you can. And you know why. Because you're strong. You're strong enough to know. You need relaxation. You need meditation. You need peace. You need tranquility. The ripples in your mind, the thoughts bombarding the shore of your mind, the constant dropping of pebbles into you, the stream of your mind has to stop. And you know that. Stop it. The ripples hitting the edges of that pond, the ripples and the stones walls are fading. No one's allowed to throw any more stones. No more stones. No more ripples. The last ripple. The last ripple. The last ripple. Fading. The last ripple. And like a sheet of ice. Like a sheet of glass. Like the smoothest marble flooring you've ever touched with your bottom of your feet. Your mind becomes a tranquil, pleasant, soothing, calm, very calm, calm place. I could sense this. You look at your own needs. You look inside. Always, always, don't look out. Don't look out at everybody else's problems. Never point fingers. Look in first. Look inward. Look inward. Wait a minute. What is there that I can fix here? Okay. What is there that I can fix here? What is there that I can fix here? Worry, worry, worry. Worry, worry, worry. Cast that out. Stop it. Stop it. And now that we've purged our mind of these thoughts, let us focus. 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 On this moment, you and I, you and I, focus on this moment. It's okay to ask for peace. It's okay to ask for tranquility, calmness, peace, hope, love. Yes, even hope and love. It's okay to ask for these things. It's okay to ask for these things in your life. To welcome these things in your life. To believe that these things can happen in your life. You're okay. You're no different than anybody else. There's a positive energy in you that knows I need this tranquility in my life. I need this calm, glassy, smooth surface in my life. This smooth glass surface. I need this in my life. I need this peaceful moment. I need this person, this Dr. Andrew Michaels, to speak to me. Speak to me. Speak to me. Just to me. He, to I. Open up my mind. Open up my spirit. Open up my energy to the universe. Let this poisons. This doubt, let this negativity go. No more. Stop with the no. Stop with the no, 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 no. Let it go. Be a friend to yourself first. And I know all of this sounds like new wave, mumbo jumbo. But think about it for a moment. If you're thinking positive about your life, if you're saying good things about you, hey, I am a good person. I matter. I love who I am. I love person I am. I'm a work in progress. I am trying to excel. I am a work in progress. I'm not giving up. I'm proud of myself. I'm proud of myself for having some integrity and some dignity. That's right. You're not a loser. You're not a failure. You set goals and standards and moral values in your life. They more than likely do not agree with mine. My goals, my plans, my moral values in life more than likely do not agree with yours. But can't we as human beings cast out all the BS of life and look at each other and say, this person has some integrity. This person has some worth, some self-worth, some self-value, some respect for themselves. I don't agree with their politics. I don't agree with their religion. I don't agree with their lifestyle, but I respect them for their integrity, and I respect them as a fellow human being for having the ability to stand up for themselves, to let themselves be known, to open themselves up to the world, and to ridicule, and to critique, and still hold themselves with their head up. Hold yourself with your head up. Do not let people put you down. Don't be closed-minded, and open your eyes and say, okay, through self-evaluation, I realize that I'm a little harsh on this, that maybe I should let this go in my life, that maybe people are right about me and this one thing. But at the same time, that one thing has kept me from having a lot of problems because I had the integrity. And I was such a forward-thinking person that I stayed the course. I stayed with it. I didn't give up on me. I didn't quit on me. There are things in life that are mistakes. We all make mistakes. I make them every day. And I bet you do too. Yeah. Yeah. But it's what you do to fix these problems in your life. That's what makes you a better person. Okay, I made a mistake. All right. People make mistakes every day. They do. But let me tell you what I did after I made that mistake. Let me show you the book I wrote after I made that one mistake in the book of life. I made that one mistake, that one error in the book of life. Let me show you the rest of the chapters. And my arm is stretched out as far as it can go. Let me show you the rest of those chapters. Don't judge me by that one page in that book. Burn that up. I've forgiven myself. I've asked for forgiveness. Forgiveness was given. Whether literally or metaphysically. And I've moved on. Why don't you move on? Why don't you agree to disagree? Why don't you allow me to have my life? Because I let you have yours. Now think about that. There's a lot of judgmental people out there that hurt you. They hurt you. You've moved on in your life. You've forgiven and you're letting them live their life. But they're not willing to let you live your life the way that you want to. Or the way that you need to. need, desire, and the facts of life, they're all different things. And you've come to a rationalization in your world, in your life, that you need this to happen to make your life functional. And yet, as you go through life allowing others to live the way they wish to, they deny you the same respect and dignity as a human being. And that's wrong. Stop thinking about this and all of this. You've done the self-reflection. You've looked inward. And you now you're looking out and saying, I'm okay with the world around me, and I'm okay with allowing people to live their lives. But I continually see people not allowing me to live the life I wish to lead. Where does it stop? And where does it start? There's a little bit of a hypocrite in all of us because we all think we're right. But it's the good person who says, let those live how they want. Let me live how I want. Don't tread on me. It's an old saying, but it's not that wrong. It's not that far from a universal truth. Don't tread on me, and I won't tread on you. In your life. That's why I came back to you. That's why I came back to you so quickly with a new Reiki hand movement. Because I could sense with the holidays coming, it's going to be a blue Christmas for some people in a tough holiday season. I'm very grateful, very happy, very pleased, very, very humble about the holiday season that I'm going to have. I'm happy for my health and the love of my family and enough wealth to make me very comfortable. And I'm very pleased, and I'm not ashamed of that. I've worked very hard for everything I have, every freaking dime. And I want you to feel that way too. Hey, you know, I work for this. I earned this. And I don't need to make excuses for anybody or anything in my life. I paid my dues, and I literally have paid my dues many times over. And where I'm going with this is me telling you about myself, but there are others who do not have a fortunate life and a blue holiday coming and a blue holiday season. We must remember them in our thoughts, and we must always make ourselves available to them. Make yourself available to help those who need help. For you. And I am there for you. Want, but I am. Want to, the desire, but I am literally here thinking about you. Worrying about you. And trying to help you. Trying desperately to help you. And with the holidays coming, part. Hold that door. Say hello. Tip your hat. Lift a heavy package. Push somebody out of the snow. That's right. Silly things. The silly little things. And say, no worries. No worries. No problem. Glad I could help. The little things. Instead of sending 100 little cuts with a razor out into the world. Send 100 comfortable handshakes to the world. Be an ambassador of humanity. Don't identify yourself as a this or that or this or that or this or that. Don't let people compartmentalize you. Be a human being. Be an ambassador for the human race. And when people try to put you down, or put you in your place, put you in that little shelf, that little display module saying, oh, that's what you are, tell them stop right there. Stop right there. I'm not doing that to you. So why are you doing it to me? And I say these things because I get asked a lot. I get asked a lot. And this is everyone. Everyone on the spectrum. So don't think I'm talking to one group here. Because you all say the same things to me. You all speak the same language of pain. Frustration. I don't understand why people won't listen. I don't understand why people won't think about what they're saying, what they're doing, what they're all. It's over and over and over. And I can't understand it. I can't understand it. The confusion and everything. And I just don't understand. I just want to be accepted. I just want people to leave me alone. I just want to be the person I want to be. I just want to live the life I want to live. Then do it. Just do it. Be the person you want to be. And forget about those people. Clear your mind of those thoughts. Clear your mind of all this bad, silly, disrespectful ugliness. And allow yourself to enjoy life again. To enjoy yourself. To enjoy those around you. Be at peace with you. Be at peace with you. And remember this holiday season. I'm here for you. If you're feeling down this season, you need a friend to talk to, you can write to me in the comments or a PM here on YouTube, and I'll try to answer back, okay? I can't be all things to all people, but if I can help one person, or if I can talk to someone and help them through this time, I'll do it. I'll try and make a friend and not an enemy, okay? I've done enough of that this year. And know that I care and that I'm here for you. That's right. I am here for you. But whether you believe it or not, you're here for me. You feed me with a purpose. And a desire to help others. I don't want to let you down. So don't you let me down. Okay? Let's do this together. All right? Yeah. Until I see all of you again, I hope you have a most blessed day. All right? Yes, and I do love all of you. I love you very much. And I do care, even if I allow a scary Grinch running around once in a while, or a guy with buckly eyes, or a big baby to frighten everyone. I think we're all adult enough to know that I have them all locked up. They're nice and safe and sound. They won't bother you anymore this Christmas. I hope. Okay? See you soon, all right? And I do love all of you very much. Bye-bye.